you know, far greater and far and work of far more importance than I do. We get paid, you know, a pittance, really. Like nurses and, you know, people that we really need. We don't really need pop groups that much.
Trying to even the score. It's all inclusive and the dirt comes free. And you can be all that you want to be.
Involved with this new McInnes film Absolute Beginners by doing a track for it. How did you get involved in that?
Well, I rang up Julian Temple when somebody told me that he was, you know, going to make a film Absolute Beginners, and I offered him our services to do the soundtrack. But he said, you know, he wanted to get more of a mixture of different people doing things, which is fair enough. And so, but he was interested in us doing something for him, so I wrote this song called Have You Ever Had It Blue. The film, and, you know, it sounds really good, doesn't it? And Gil's, what's his name? He's an old geezer, Gil Evans, jazz arranger. He done a really, really good horn arrangement on it, which sounds brilliant, you know, and strings as well on it. So, you know, it should be out next year sometime in the spring, I think.
Are you a real fan of the book? Is that why you wanted to get involved?
Yeah, I've always liked the book. Well, I say always. I only read it a few years ago, but, you know, I thought it was a really good book. I mean, I don't know whether it's factual or not, it probably isn't, but I don't think that's important. It's just the kind of impression it makes upon you.
Would you be disappointed then if the film didn't live up to the novel, especially with your band being involved?
Yeah, it would obviously be disappointing, but it's taken a musical approach, so maybe that's a good idea, you know, a bit kind of like an English West Side Story or something, which could be interesting.
Do you fancy getting involved in any more film soundtrack, like, you know, Rambo 3 or something?
I certainly not. There's a possibility we might be doing something next year for this young girl's written this screenplay, and a few people are interested, and it's about trade unionism, which would be quite good for us as well, because it's something we could, you know, I think we could write about and have a lot to say. So that's a possibility, but yeah, if the subject matter was right, we'd do it.
Do you have no sort of international leanings? Are you ever disappointed you were born an ordinary London lad?
No, because I was always born in Surrey.
Well, an ordinary English lad, then.
No, I'm quite happy the way I am, you know. I do like a lot of things about the continent. I like France and Italy a lot. And I think generally in Europe there seems to be a much more relaxed feeling amongst people. I think English people find it hard to relax and enjoy themselves unless they're drunk.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know. It just seems to be in our character, really. Maybe it's a bit of the stiff upper lip stuff, you know. A bit of a hangover from that.
What kind of things are they more relaxed about? You mean just about going out to gigs, or just about life in general?
Well, I suppose I'm sort of judging it on when I see English people abroad, Englishmen abroad. They always just seem a little bit uptight to me. They're just enjoying themselves and not, you know, not having to put on a kind of show of, you know, dignified.
Do you think Yeah, well, I mean, you actually tour the world, but you're working. I mean, do you think you get enough time off when you're playing to see a country well enough to
too much
to go
time
back?
No. If you've got to do one or the other, so if I'm working, if we're touring, then I just want to go there and work and do the concerts and leave it at that. If I'm going on holiday, then I'll do something else. I'll just relax and, you know, look around. I don't like mixing the two. And the only thing we had, like, this last tour we done, we had 10 concerts in a month, which meant a lot of hanging about. And, you know, it does drive you mad after a while.
Do you think there's enough encouragement for very young people to start up their own bands or anything, even when you're still
Doll,
at school?
The Doll's quite a good thing.
Well, apart from that,
quite a good, encouragement.
I mean, obviously all the independent labels and everything seem to be, you know, closing up very quickly because of lack of financial aid. Can Respond help at all?
Well, we can do if we find the right people and the people we really want to back and we feel strongly about. But over the last sort of 2 years, before this re-signing with Polydor, I was using all my own money. And it was just going down a pan and I couldn't really keep on doing that, you know, because I'm not a multi-millionaire.
You're not?
No.
That's surprising. We've always read that you were a millionaire, even though you wear vests. You do have a bob or two, though.
Oh, yeah, no, I'm not complaining, you know. But at the same time, people want to send checks in, of course, I've always been accepted.
Paul Weller looking cool and tanned in his designer vest. And the tan incident is not from his sunbed because we caught him in London. In the middle of his world tour, he was just off to Italy. The lucky.
Today is